In today's class, we'll discuss Fourier transform of real exponential signal. It is given as x of t is equal to e power minus a t u of t. The Fourier transform formula is given as x of omega is equal to integral minus infinity to plus infinity x of t e power minus j omega t dt. So in the place of x of t, substitute e power minus a t u of t. It can be written as integral minus infinity to plus infinity e power minus a t u of t e power minus j omega t dt. We know that u of t is a step signal. It is having the value 1 if t value is greater than or equal to 0, and it is having value 0 for t less than 0. Since it is u of t here, this integral becomes integral 0 to infinity, because u of t value will be 0 for t less than 0. So that is why the integral becomes 0 to infinity e power minus a t. Now we just remove u of t. We define u of t is 1 for t greater than or equal to 0. So the definition of u of t is used in this integral. So it is 0 to infinity e power minus a t e power minus j omega t dt. Now this can be written as integral 0 to infinity e power minus a plus j omega t dt. Now this can be written as e power minus a plus j omega t by minus a plus j omega. We just do this integration, substitute the limits 0 to infinity. Now substitute the upper limit. So if you substitute upper limit, e power minus infinity is 0, and minus, and here we have minus again, minus minus, so it becomes plus. Substitute t is equal to 0, so e power 0 value is 1, divided by a plus j omega will get. So what is x of omega we will be getting here? X of omega is equal to 1 by a plus j omega. So for e power minus a t u of t, the Fourier transform is 1 by a plus j omega. Now we find out what is magnitude and phase response. To find out magnitude response, what is that we do? We multiply and divide with conjugate of denominator. So it is 1 minus a minus j omega divided by a plus j omega into a minus j omega. If you do this, what we get here, we will be getting the value. It is given as a minus j omega by, it is a plus j omega, it is a plus j omega into a minus j omega. It is in the form a minus b into a plus b. So it is a square minus b square. So it is a square minus b square is j omega whole square. So j square is 1, no? So j square is minus 1, so minus minus becomes plus. So it can be written as a minus j omega by a square plus omega square. So this is our x of omega. So from this we will be writing what is magnitude. The magnitude is given as, we write this in the polar form. If you write this in polar form, this can be written like this. It is 1 by root of a square plus omega square. Angle is minus tan inverse omega by a. So what is the magnitude? The magnitude is mod x of omega is equal to 1 by square root of a square plus omega square is magnitude, and this is the angle. What is the angle here? The angle is angle x of omega is equal to, it is minus tan inverse omega by a, omega by a. So like this we can find out magnitude and phase, and finally we can plot magnitude and phase. If you plot magnitude response, the magnitude response will be like this here. So it is mod x of omega, so it is given like this with respect to omega, and the phase response is given like this. So if you find out just phase for different values of omega, the maximum phase will be varying from pi by 2 to minus pi by 2. It is the maximum phase varying with respect to omega. So like this we can find out magnitude and phase response. Thank you.